Everyone, in this video we are going to discuss about WCF. First, we have questions and its answers, all questions. So, here the question is explain WCF architecture and also explain its fundamentals. Usually, WCF is most important feature when you are going to reach into the services. When we are using .NET 2.0 or 3.0, we are using web services, which is ASMS. After that, we use WCF services. And we have the using the WebA. Many options now. So technology is growing. So now, the WCF is very big concept and famous. You must know about architecture. So WCF is a framework for building SOA, service oriented application, by which we can send asynchronous message and data from one service endpoint to another service endpoint. See, here the endpoint is address by name and contact. This is endpoint. Without knowing address or by name, contract one time, yeah. See, WCF is a runtime and a set of APIs, application programming interface for creating systems that sends messages between services and usually this is the one. Send message between service and client. This is the main thing. The same infrastructure and APIs used to create applications that communicate with other applications in the same computer system or on a system that is in another company and is accessed over the internet. Yeah, you can access over the internet or access over the intranet or you can access over the system to system, whatever it is. The fundamentals is complex services, component object model, which is component. Services, that is ASMS. .NET remote is another feature, and Microsoft Message Queue, MSMQ. This is very important, Queue Message. Why we need for Microsoft Message Queue, MSMQ? See, thing, suppose you are creating a service. You have already created the ASMS service. Think like that. You already created the ASMS service. Now, why I need to know WCF, MSMQ, WCF, MSMQ? See, here the thing is ASMS service will create one to one option. But in MSMQ, suppose I have 100 images. These 100 images has different image formats, maybe PNG or JPG, etc. Okay. Now, my images has to pass services to client, pass to client one by one, but I need all the 100. So In the case, how I can get message, how I can get reply in SMS, that is not true. But here in Microsoft message queuing, I have if one image is going to the past to the server, the next image will to the queue, it will get the response. Reply and response will get immediately. So that's the reason we are moving to MQ WCF. And interoperability, service orientation, architecture, that's all about. And what about the WCF architecture? There are four major layers, yes. And provide what are the four major layers? That is data conduct, data. Policy and binding, that is operation. You can mention as operation content. So this is the four layers. These are data content layer, message content layer, operation content layer, service content layer. These are the four layers. Instead of ASMS, service methods, here we have the methods operation contract. So here, what are the service runtime, throttling behavior. So throttling behavior is when you sending message, that is duplex or reply, response and reply, that type of, and error handling, all under the throttling behavior, and error behavior, metadata behavior, data within the data, that metadata behavior. Instead of W best listed of month, metadata behavior will happen here, and instance behavior, message behavior based on the message contact layer, and transaction, what are the transactions is going on, and dispatch and concurrency and the parameters between everything into the service runtime. How the message will run? Security channel, HTTP channel, HTTP, TCP. These are the protocol for sending and receiving messages. MSMQ and named by HTTP, TCP transaction and encoder. We have a lot of encoders, binary. So it will encode and decode the messages and text and XML kind of things. And one more thing is how the activation and posting is done. So then the WCF can post and activate through Windows Active and Service, EXE, Windows Services, Complex. We have four options. So this is the architecture currently used. So in depth of architecture, we have endpoint, address, binding, and contact, ABC. So through endpoint, it will run, it will get returned as plugs and duplex method, a lot of things are going there. So we will see in next question how it will go. How can you actually operation overloading while exposing WCF? The operation overloading. Okay, so most of the people, you know how overload. So overload and override option also in C sharp. So the same CG here in ASMS. If you have ASMS web service already, you know how overload will happen. Suppose you have two methods. Method one is getting user name. Method two is, see here, method one is getting user first name. After 2 years, letting those are last name. So thing like that. So suppose I'm declaring the method getting user then the over the based on the name attribute. So attribute is here, the attribute is different. Getting user first name, getting user last name. Suppose I'm sending get user. Created two methods, get user. How it will work? It will not work in operation context. So you have to mention different name attributes. Get user first name, get user last name. So by default, Wistel doesn't support operational overloading. Overloading can be achieved by name property of the operation command. So here you have mentioned operation method name equal to some integer, operation method name equal to some property, suppose. So here integer sum and double sum. Yes. The same if you are going name, the name attribute is first name and last name. We can actually overload it. When the box will be generated for these operations, it will have two methods with different names. So box will generate methods. So Wistel will not support Wistel .find will not support operation overloading. Okay, let's move to third question. What message exchange patterns? Yeah, maps is more. Support PWC. So that's message exchange pattern. Suppose you are sending message to particular client. So your service is going to send suppose you are running your own robot. So you want to tell your client your robot are running successfully completed. Robot successfully completed. So this message you want to send through message exchange pattern. So it's okay to send one way. You don't need to get any response. Robot is successfully completed. Yes. That is one way. Request and response. Suppose you are sending exception. Robot is not completed. It has the issue. Please clarify this issue. So then you will get response from client or server. That issue was cleared. So you need that request and response. Problems, that is different. So this is the way we can achieve maps in service. Duplex method is different. Request and response are one way completed with the duplex method. Okay guys, let's see more questions in our